factor.
Yeah, well, maybe if he can. There he is.
Look at that face, Andy. Come on, I know you like dogs. You like this dog, don't you?
He just came to hang out.
Aw, that's awesome.
Where's my shot so I can walk home?
By the way, you guys, this is Chris's roommate, Anne.
Yeah,
meet
Anne.
Give it up for Anne. Thank you for joining us.
Lives all day, so.
Man, the dog, you look
no,
so
really
sad.
I haven't been in EMT school all day.
All right, let's so give Anne a shot of vodka.
Why is this, like,
what are you doing in? What are you doing in town?
Because we're classy.
What? I'm going to a wedding.
Why?
Oh, yeah?
Oh, I have so many of those. Are you gonna make me do it by myself?
Cheers.
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 Welcome.
Cheers.
Cheers. Love you.
Not for dogs. Not for dogs.
Yeah, I'm in LA going to a wedding, and then
it's week vodka.
Tuesday I go to Vegas for a week to do shows. So.
Oh yeah, where are you gonna do your shows?
At Harrah's.
I know.
Nice, very nice.
High five.
Very nice. Right opposite the
High
Mirage.
High five.
Yeah, pretty much.
Let's do this.
Oh no, she's like.
Do you want to plug the dates?
Yeah. Which one
you
do I look
at?
Plastic.
This
come on,
one.
Buddy.
The one point to the dog.
The small one.
Okay. I'll be at Harrah's.
And I asked
the
guy. I know, right?
I'll be at Harrah's March 29th through April 3rd.
He's beautiful.
Performing stand-up comedy. And we're excited that you're able to come join us and auction off an item. Do you
want to? I brought something from home.
Let's just kick it off with your item.
Yeah. This I left this at my old house.
He's cute.
This is a bowl made out of an Elvis Presley Christmas album.
Yes.
It's an album. It's got Blue Christmas, Silent Night, White Christmas, Santa Claus is Back in Town, I'll Be Home for Christmas, and on this side it has Every Day Was Like Christmas, Here Comes Santa Claus, Oh Little Town of Bethlehem, Santa Bring My Baby Back to Me, Mama Liked the Roses, and one song is with the Jordanaires and the Imperials Quartet. So, what is the, how much, I don't know, what does this start at?
Well, where do you want it to start at?
Well, what do you think is a fair price?
I don't know. I'm guessing, I know.
$10!
I know someone start within at $10. Earshot wants to buy this from you.
Who wants
so
to buy an Elvis
starting
bowl?
At $10, Chris, say,
Chris,
you
said you wanted
bowl,
this, right? $10.
This Elvis record bowl, which you said you wanted.
I really want this bowl.
Loki wants it.
I really want this bowl. I saw
see,
as soon as this went up on the website, I was like, I want this. I want this whole thing.
Like, bitch, that's mine.
Massive Elvis fan.
He is pushing.
Amazing. Well, we have this lovely item that is great for anyone that likes Elvis. It's great for anyone that needs a bowl.
Anyone likes
great
bowls?
For anyone that wants a conversation starter.
It will
piece.
Not hold liquid though, because there's a hole.
Oh, there's a hole. So don't use it for
don't
your
use this
punch
for cereal.
Bowl. Not a
dry
great
cereal.
Idea.
Okay, but then you're a weirdo. Cereal with no milk is all right.
By the way, I love your total nerd watch that you have on. Like, where did you get that? 1985?
Target. Also $10.
Wow. Are you
just like the price of this bowl.
Well, someone please buy this watch.
I like this watch. This is not for sale. I get more compliments on this watch than any nice watch I've ever owned.
Are you serious? This is like a legit nerd watch, Andy. This is hilarious to me.
It has a stopwatch.
Not even nerds wear watches like that.
All the time.
Even nerds have
cooler watches. I use the stopwatch.
Okay,
awesome.
Your iPhone has one.
I know, but I don't have to pull this out. I can just go like this and do it on the slide.
I think a fly just landed on my face.
Well, how long is it going to be there? I can time it.
Went away. It already happened. I don't know if your watch is that fast. Oh, man, Andy. You know
could
what?
Be. It's not the watch. It's up to me.
I know you like cats.
So did anyone bid on this yet?
I don't know. Can anyone tell us if this item has been bid on yet? I'm assuming it must have.
I was over there bidding
so cool.
on it. I want it.
You did?
I really want it. If this doesn't sell, guys, I'm having this.
Yeah, Chris actually told me this. I was going to tell you this earlier that Chris wanted it.
Yeah, I'm a massive
Elvis fan. But I was like, I'm
going to
let this
fan.
Happen on air.
That's
so
cool.
Am I.
Massive Elvis fan. I got the True Romance tattoo on the arm.
Oh, nice.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's me, right? That day with my boobs out.
Oh, yeah. There was one day where were you?
I was at your house. We were filming segments. So I was wearing a wife beater.
And she had very specific Patricia Arquette boobs
popping
out of her shirt.
Patricia
nice.
Arquette boobs.
That's what was going on.
Yeah, that was what was happening.
I can't thank you enough for coming on. You're like, I know you're busy. You're up like Berkeley and Vegas.
Yeah,
he's
all over the place.
I cannot thank you enough for coming on here.
No, I saw Erin today and she was like, come on the show. And I was like, okay, I'll do it.
Sounds
pretty cool.
Pop in segments.
Pop it in segments. I'm glad that we have this lovely bowl. You guys don't forget about this item. It is up on the website, and you guys can go ahead and make bids on that all night long, or else Chris is going to get it.
I'm going to get it.
Wait, so when does the auction close?
I don't know why I'm holding this.
What day is it today? Thursday.
Thursday.
Friday night at midnight.
Okay.
Yeah.
because a lot of people in Europe tend to replay the show.
Really?
Yeah.
And what is the website URL? We should probably let
I did think there was going to be live bidding. I thought it was going to be very exciting. Like, I could
they
see
do.
The numbers go
but
up.
There
oh,
is.
We should really
yeah.
do that.
Yeah.
It's just not updated. It's in live time. But, yep. you know.
I wonder what it's at now.
I don't know.
We'll look
it could
at
be
it.
A whole
look at
$11.
And you guys, the website is csbodypiercing.com/XSN. Remember, you can go there through tonight,
XSN.
Tomorrow, XSN, and you guys can get this lovely item and join it to your collectibles. Hey, it's going to be great. I'm really glad that this is going so well tonight. We're 10 minutes in, and this is going to be an exciting show because a lot of cool things have happened this week.
Yeah? What else has happened?
It is a... The item is at $10.
Oh, it's still at $10. So $10. Someone's bid on it.
I'm looking at it right
now. Are you not bid on it yet, Chris?
Oh.
What's happening?
Good news.
What?
You got banned from Twitch again.
Already?
Already, yeah.
This
banned
is
from
insane.
What?
Twitch. We
what
get
is
banned
Twitch?
From Twitch every episode.
We got, not banned, just suspended.
What is Twitch?
Because we're not.
It's a live streaming website,
yeah.
primarily for gamers.
Are on it.
And we do, that's one of the networks we broadcast on. We never get banned, we just get suspended.
For
it's,
what?
Drinking, saying the F-bomb, anything
general
really.
General debauchery,
yeah.
being
Dogs,
loud and annoying.
Yeah.
Oh, being not creative. We weren't creative enough. Well,
oh,
Chris
really?
Wasn't,
so
but
creative.
I've never been banned. Is my Twitch connected today, you guys?
Possibly.
Possibly.
Omar
first
in
time
the house.
I've heard of Twitch.
You guys, can you please put my Twitch on since... His
I'm gonna go
Twitch
check this.
Let
me get this. Let me get the rundown.
Yeah.
Wait,
why don't, okay. We're gonna
I'm
let Chris figure
that,
out.
Heard
and while
Twitch
he does that, you know what? I'm gonna pull out one of my auction items, and it's
oh,
awesome.
No.
And there's a full story that goes with it.
Oh yeah.
Yep.
I'm not mic'd up. I don't even know if people can hear me. Yes.
I can hear you. Yeah. We got a boom right there for you guys. All right. Is my Twitch connected?
Content violation.
That sounds dirty.
On yours?
Yeah, violation.
But what about mine?
Because you can't say is my Twitch connected on Twitch.
No, I just I feel like I don't know.
If anyone in the back watching the show knows whether or not my Twitch is connected, can you let us know? Because now that Chris is off...
I love these terms. Is my Twitch connected?
We want to be able to Twitch on my Twitch all night long, you know
violating
what I'm saying?
Violating content.
Okay, my first item of the night...
Give it.
Is my... This isn't even a ticket that I use, because I was so VIP, I didn't even need a ticket.
Oh,
shit! Oh, shit! Yeah, you guys. So, Monday night, I randomly had a surprise. I didn't even think this was going to happen. I ended up basically on stage with Coheed and Cambria, singing all of their fucking songs with them. And I'm sorry, we're going to get banned from Twitch forever.
Where was mine?
Because of what I'm saying right now. But it was the most amazing time of my life. I didn't even use this, but I had it because the person that I was hanging out with, who happened to just kind of know everyone there, gave it to me, and I thought, you know what, I will auction this off. And we have a video that we're going to throw to you right now,
oh, damn.
So you guys can see where I was on stage on Monday night at the Hollywood Palladium, and it was amazing. It was an incredible night. Dude.
Where was I at this point?
I know.
Yeah.
I wish I was Snapchatting
I was in New York.
I was like, Chris, guess where I am? I didn't, okay, honestly, this is what happened.
Friends don't stop.
I was catching
friends,
up
friends
with a friend who was gone. He was like, he's been gone on the road. He works for another band. He's like a roadie for that band Revolution. And we've been friends for a lot of years. And he's like, hey, I'm in town. I have a couple days off. Do you want to catch up?
How many years? A lot of years?
Yeah, like 4 or 5 years. In LA, that's like a lifetime. So we're catching up over happy hour because he's back in town. And then he randomly gets a text message and says, hey, do you want to go like... hang out like on stage like at this show at the Palladium, and I was like, Coheed and Cambria, and he's like, yeah, if we're there in 10 minutes we can like go do that. And I was like, yes. And I was wearing heels because I came from an audition, so I bought these shoes at Urban Outfitters. I bought these Vans
and
wait, I like,
what did you
ran.
Do with your heels?
I put them in my backpack.
Okay.
Yeah, and then I just went and sat on stage, and here's what happened, you guys. This is how close I was. Check it out. It upside down, and then he flips it over and starts licking it, and I was like, wow.
He looks like a licker.
Husband material.
A
you know what
licker.
I'm saying?
Husband material.
I wish he'd lit it on fire and kept playing.
Oh, wow, it was incredible. One of the best nights ever, and so that's the story behind this ticket that you guys can now buy.
Yeah,
it's
so
available.
If you guys want, you can bid on an experience that didn't happen to you, that you wish had happened to you,
there you go.
But possibly you never will.
You could put on your bulletin board and say you've been there.
Yeah.
Yes, you can, and you know what? I will sign it, and I will get Chris to sign it, and that's almost as good as being on stage competing in Cambria.
They might even rip the tab off, so it looks like you actually went.
You know
what? Is the tab still on there?
Yeah, because I didn't have to use it.
That's some special
But do they
shit.
Actually rip the tab anymore, or do they just...
I don't really know.
They use their, like, supermarket checkout machine.
I'm not sure, but you know what? I will lick it, and I'll play it upside down if someone
If you
decides.
Lick it, it's going to go up. Just watch. Oh, that's like $15
lick it,
now.
Lick it like a leprechaun. Lick it. Lick it.
Oh, God.
Whoops.
Yes, you guys, my life.
Too soon?
You know, I was thinking about actually quoting Morgan on Twitter and just saying, my life, dash Morgan. Who will appear in one of our other segments today that I cannot wait to watch, actually. I saw the beginning of it, and I was like, what is this?
This is a segment we filmed after... There's a members-only exclusive club on a Tuesday night in Hollywood called Cloak and Dagger, where you have to have this, like, mysterious little black car
to get into. Yeah.
And we went there, we got absolutely trashed, and then we were feeling very refined and very exclusive, so when we got home, we filmed this segment, which you'll see later.
Where was I at that point?
You were going to Coheed and Cambria shows without me. That's where you were, obviously. Fraternizing with your band friends.
Oh, okay. I know. I thought of you, though. I thought of you at least ten times.
I'm not disappointed. I'm not any...
I did. I thought about Chris.
I was so apathetic about
it. British.
And, he's okay. British, so it means nothing to him. But you know what? Cheers. Well, just cheers because you guys...
Well, I can't hold a relationship down, too.
Oh, neither can I, but I'm American.
British,
well,
so you
I'm
can
Mexican,
attract them, but you
I guess.
Just can't keep it.
Yeah, I'm kind of the same way.
Or is it just that we drink too much?
Could be that, too. That's what we do. Oh, by the way, you guys, happy reminder, you can buy us $5 shots if you go on our website.
$5 shots all night. We're like a country bar.
So $5
we are.
Shots?
It's like being at the Outpost.
So what happens when
it's
they
classy,
pay $5 to drink
it's
some of
scary,
this?
Yeah. There's rapists. Oh, hi. I cannot wait. Okay.
Hi, Pierre
good evening,
Kelly.
Everyone.
Yeah, Kelly says good evening.
Pierre says he can't wait to hear the new song. You know what? The new song is featuring Dina, who is here right now, who you guys will meet later on the show.
Dina Renee featuring Chris and Erin.
Yeah, featuring Chris and Erin. And she's a very talented singer-songwriter and vocalist, and we can't wait for you guys to meet her and to see this amazing video that I've been working on all week long.
She's also wearing a hat
because it's called Hey Hipster, Can I Wear Your Hat? So, you guys, stay tuned for that. It's gonna be the very last bit of the show, so you have
just
to watch
to
for the whole
watching.
Hour. Unfortunately,
gotta hook you.
Gotta hook you in, and that's what we do here. Oh, why was that necessary?
You started. You talked about licking and fucking boyfriend material and stuff
ridiculous.
Like that.
I said husband material.
Licking your boyfriend
that's
material.
That's different. Ugh. That is so different. He knows.
You know,
he was like, yeah, you know.
I know, I've been married once.
That's true, I know. We talked about that today, actually.
We did. We had a long phone call.
We did have a long phone call.
They left
call.
You apparently the best voicemail you've ever heard in your entire life.
I wonder if I can play it.
Man, she said that to me, too.
Should I
it
play
wasn't,
it?
It wasn't the best voicemail.
It was actually really funny. If I play a voicemail, you guys, will it pick up on my mic? Okay.
Oh,
no?
We're going to plug straight in.
Oh, okay, you guys.
Holy
you know
shit.
What?
What we're gonna do for you guys is we're gonna play this voicemail and then we're gonna shoot to our drunk correspondent Sheila Chalakee.
Yeah.
Shanina. Okay. Two shots already.
All right.
Shanina Chalakee.
Play.
Sinead O'Connor.
This is Chris today.
Right up there. Right up in there.
It's not in there?
It's not in there.
Damn it.
Let me get this out of there.
Oh, man. Oh.
We got production problems.
I know. Okay. Okay.
It's just like your relationships.
Production
How's
problems.
That, guys?
So many. You guys are good?
We're not getting this.
It's cool.
We got it.
Okay. You know what? We'll do it next time.
We'll come back to that.
I'll export it as an MP3 and we'll play it professionally for you guys.
But it's technical, Erin.
But enough
I know,
of the technical aspects.
Erin will export it as an
MP3,
people. Get ready.
Hey, guys. It's 9:20 and 25 seconds. You know what that means?
It means time for another segment.
It means we're going to go to our drunk correspondent, Sheila Chalakee, who has been doing
Yay.
A segment for us each week called How to Do
you
It Drunk.
You know Sheila?
You know Sheila?
You know,
oh, I do know Sheila.
Yeah.
So she does a segment for us called How to Do It Drunk. Last week she explained how to talk to the police drunk. And this week she's gonna teach us how to make a booty call.
Yeah, which I'm excited about because I don't know how to do that.
That's all I know how to do.
You're alone, liquored up, and lying in a king-size bed made for two. It's booty call or bust. This week on How to Do a Drunk, we're gonna get you laid. We're gonna get you some. Step one, determine the object of your desire. Scroll through your text messages. Has anyone sent you a message between the hours of midnight and 3 a.m. recently? Or a dick pic in the last 12 months? Either are great choices for your prey. Step two, initiate contact. Pique their interest with a clever, well thought out, flirty little text. Hey, you up? Step three, keep their attention. No response back, keep texting. Hey, 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 hey. Why the fuck isn't he texting me back? Send nudes. Step four, send nudes. Everyone knows the quickest way to get is to give. This is also true with naked photos. Now, I know that you're wasted, but this probably is going to end up on the internet, so keep it professional. Consider the angles and the framing. Now, it's going to be hard to pick just one photo, so send between 4 and 5, because 6 makes you look needy. Step 5, realize you've been texting the wrong person. Apologize to your dad and go the fuck to sleep. Thanks for watching this week's episode of How to Do It Drunk. I'm Sheila Chalakee, you're drunk. Back to Chris and Erin at the studio.
And thank you, Sheila Chalakee. Oh my God, that audio was sexy. I've never sounded more like a genie than I did right there. And yes, I can make all your wishes come true.
Damn, or at least just 3.
Or yeah. She could sell you a ticket to Coheed and Cambria.
Yes!
That is expired.
Yeah, but if you're her friend, she might not take you.
And I licked it. So that's all I'm going to say about that. And I love you, Chris. You were there in my heart. If I had more than 10 minutes notice, you would have been the first person I called. And I genuinely mean that.
That's nice.
On that note, Andy, thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks so much.
Thank you for your years of friendship and awesomeness.
Is it a lot of years?
Yes, it's like 4 or 5 in LA.
We're
going to
take one of these for the road, guys.
Go for it.
Road. And then I'll finish this one.
And we'll see you
guys later.
Yeah.
Good
Wait,
luck.
Do you want to give him a shout out again one more time?
Yeah,
buy
this.
On Twitter and
you can follow me on Twitter at his name is Andy. Also, I have shows next week in Las Vegas at Harrah's Resort and Casino at the Improv at Harrah's. I'm there the 29th through the 3rd. So I think it starts every night at 8:30. I'll be there. That'll be
fun.
I might be there, actually. I'm going
to
be there.
Come to Vegas. Yeah.
Might go, too, actually. Let's just all go to Vegas.
Drop Shopping Network, Vegas.
Okay.
You can get tickets. I got a $40 flight to Vegas from LA.
Oh, I'm down.
It's ridiculous.
Let's make that happen.
Yeah.
All right, you guys.
Come on,
go support Andy.
I'm bored.
In Vegas.
I'm stuck on the strip all week. It's like fucking hell.
Just tweet him. He'll hang out with you.
Violin.
Yeah.
Bye, Andy.
Thank you.
See you later.
This got bored.
My gosh. Now,
this.
I know you're going to try to steal this bowl, and I don't want you to do that because I want everyone else to have an opportunity to get this amazingness. But if you don't, Chris is going to take it.
I get a little klepto
when I'm
drunk.
And you're going to miss out. Yeah.
When I've had a couple, I get a little Winona.
And if you guys don't take this Coheed and Cambria ticket, you don't auction bid on this, I'm going to put it in my special box of memories where it should be. But I'm an amazing, generous person, so I took it out.
I literally
so I
thought you were
going to
leave that. I'm going to put it in my special box.
Oh, no. But I should have just left it.
So
there,
glad you. So glad
awesome.
You put at memory. Memories at the end.
Oh my God! Well, speaking of special boxes, special stories, we have our next guest who has a lot of amazing things to talk about and some fun things that she has found in her closet that she's going to share with us tonight. One of my good friends and one of the most talented, amazing people I know. Come out, Tatiana Carrier. Hi, guys. So glad that you're here with us tonight. I'm really looking forward to this, just mainly based on the pictures that you send of this auction item. Should we just kick things off and get right into it?
Get
okay,
into it.
So this highly flammable object.
Why do you say that? Why do you say highly flammable?
It's spandex and it's so, like, just touch it.
Have you tried setting fire to it?
Yes.
I love the fact that you had the confidence to wear this. I would look ridiculous in this.
And I couldn't
Me
wear
also.
A bra either, guys. Like, look at the back. This was my prom dress.
This is the hottest dress I've ever seen in my life.
How old were you?
All the way up to here.
Were you always 6 foot tall?
Yes, I was.
Holy crap.
Okay, so here's the story behind this slutty dress. I grew up in Montgomery County, Maryland, super preppy, went to private school my entire life. And I didn't want to be like all the basic bitches and get a dress from Macy's, so I flew to Miami. Real aggressive.
Fuck Macy's, guys. That's what we're saying here. If we're saying anything, we're saying fuck Macy's.
So my best friend and I went to Miami for spring break. We were like, we're going to get some dresses. We're going to look better than everyone at prom. And we did. And I got this dress.
Yes!
And the slits basically came up to here. My dad is Armenian, and he was like, oh my god, he was freaking out. Like,
he was like, hey bro.
He was like, don't do this. But yeah, and I wore no bra, so yeah.
How old are you when you get a prom?
18?
Yeah,
all right,
something
that's
like that. I guess it depends
totally
on what the prom rules are in your high school, right?
And I had no boobs, so it's like no bras, no problem.
Yeah, you could do it. That's
totally
fine.
Do it.
Yeah.
I'm like Billy Elliot. It's like no boobs.
So if any of you creepy guys are out there that want to buy a small flammable dress that an 18-year-old has rubbed.
Really?
Oh, you did?
No.
I was like, keep that.
No. I
keep that and give it to your granddaughter.
She didn't. She took it off before she lost her virginity. She didn't lose her virginity in it.
You know what's funny, though, is I have a dress like this I should have brought if I had thought about it, but my senior prom was yellow, and it had a slit up to here, but only on one side, and it was one shoulder, and I also had to wear no bra. I had to wear those sticker.
What is wrong with proms in this country?
It was like a band-aid that went all around your boob. I had to wear one of those, and but my pictures looked great, but I think in person it must have looked weird.
I was bronzed, and it was like
no, I know. You sent us a picture. Do we have a picture that we can pull up? Do you guys have that in the asset folder? Because it might be on the auction site.
Looks like the
note.
Looks like the note.
Oh, it's on the auction site. Did you guys say in the asshat folder?
No, the asset.
Like the assets? Oh, I thought you said asshat.
Yeah, I meant to say asset.
Sorry.
Yeah, sorry.
Asset.
Did I mispronounce that?
Cultural.
Tecate. By the way, would you like to partake in any of this?
I'm okay. I'm like embarrassed enough right now.
This is an amazing piece.
This is great.
It's free.
You guys.
It's just auction.
It's free.
It's at $30 right now.
By the way, just to let you know, this was $400. And in high school, $400 was a pretty penny.
That was $400?
I'm such a loser. I was like, oh my god, it says made in Paris. Okay, take all my money.
Oh my god, there's the dress! There it is!
There I am!
My gosh!
They're going to throw it up on the screen in a second.
Can we throw to this?
Oh, that was my best friend, Tommy.
I'm just seeing how well this
was
is made for $400.
Date? No, my prom date was my high school boyfriend that I did not bring a picture of.
Why?
Because it's, you know, it's a touchy subject.
It's complicated. Yeah,
it's complicated.
I get it.
Let's put it in the Elvis bowl.
Why not?
There we go.
That was my best friend, Tommy.
Yeah, it's like a salad bowl full of shade.
And you do look really tan. Oh
I know,
my God.
Guys.
Was that real or was that spray?
Oh, no. It was fake and bake. I actually went in the tanning bed.
Fake and bake.
I'm so embarrassed
Holy
about
shit.
That.
Well, girl, you look good.
Look at my hair. Like, what am I doing with my life?
Yeah. That's what everyone did in high school.
I feel
probably
like
what everyone
bigger
still
boobs
does.
In high school than I do now. I'm trying to figure out what happened. My boobs look great, guys.
Oh my gosh.
We're not getting it on the screen. It hasn't come up yet. We might get it there in a second.
Oh,
but,
wait. Are we getting this? Can
here we
see
go.
This?
We can get this.
Can we share
it's a great prom
this
photo.
It's a great. We're sitting on top of a limo.
It is. And can I just say
on top of a limo?
Yeah.
You have not aged at all. Like, you look exactly the same.
I do?
Yes. Are you serious?
I mean, kind of. I look great.
You look amazing.
I love this female thing where you guys can look at photos and go, I look great.
I was a babe in high school.
Yeah, look at that.
There we go. It's up to $30 right now.
I was queen in this.
You
so,
were?
So even more happened.
Yeah, you guys, that dress is worth
a lot.
First of all, you guys know it costs $400, but all the experiences associated with it, you could get that and feel like prom queen.
It's just shadows
you know?
Of the
or
American.
Or like Tatiana. I mean, which is better? They're both pretty cool.
I mean, I might buy
that dress.
It's just shadows of the American political system. Like, the person that pays the most and puts the biggest investment in can be the queen, the prom queen.
You can pay to be queen.
Yeah, it's good.
Just fly to Miami, pay to be queen.
Yeah, pay to be queen. That's what goes on. You can do this in small Middle Eastern countries too. You can literally pay to be queen.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that how it works?
Central, mid, was it West Eastern European countries?
Really?
Not Middle Eastern.
I feel like in Mexico, you just like sell the most drugs, and that's how you get in charge of things. That's where I'm from, so.
Well, that's where we are now. We're in Los Angeles. That's pretty much how that works too.
Yeah, pretty crazy.
Holy crap!
Did we get that picture out?
I think we've given up on it.
Oh, what? Okay, good. Just want to make sure.
Thanks, guys. Sorry.
Want to make sure everyone saw.
This isn't sober shopping network. It's drunk shopping network. Did you want to crack a beer?
Sure. You know what?
You know what?
The flammable dress is out. Let's set it on fire. Double the price.
Oh, you guys can buy the ashes because that's how we roll.
We have to do a shot.
Oh, really?
Somebody bought us a shot.
Well, I mean, I feel like that can count, by the way, because that's a brand new beer.
Let me see who bought us a shot and we'll do this.
Maybe I'll really lose my virginity tonight.
For realsies.
Chris is like, please.
He's like, what?
All right, let's see who bought us this.
Okay.
Who bought it?
Morgan, not funny.
What?
Morgan? What? Why?
Morgan is one of our drunk correspondents. You'll see a video of her later. Absolutely shit-faced.
Yeah, we made her a Morgan 911 package and auctioned it off a couple episodes ago with some hangover mints and some ibuprofen and a towel for bodily fluids. So she has all those things now, and
she does have bodily fluids.
People actually bought some for her. So now we give them to her because our generous watchers here decided that it was a worthy cause. So, you know, support a Morgan.
I didn't get any liquid on the dress. It's had enough.
Oh, my God. No, are we?
Too soon.
Too soon. You were 18. It's not too soon.
That was like last week.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, guys. Oh. Cheers. If you want to go on the website, csbodypiercing.com/XSN, you can buy us all a shot for $5, which is ridiculous. Morgan just did it right now.
Thanks, Morgan. You're
just joining us, my name is Chris Saints. This is Erin Darling.
Hello.
And this is Miss Tatiana.
Hello. Yeah.
I don't know what I just did.
Yeah.
Cheers, guys.
Cheers. You know, we just like jumped into this whole segment talking about the dress before we kind of like introduced you. Do you want to tell the audience like where they can follow you and support your projects, et cetera, et cetera?
Sure. I never use social media.
I know.
But you can follow me if you want to see a lot of pictures of my French bulldog.
You have a lot of followers on Twitter.
I know, but I don't ever tweet. Like, I just retweet other people's stuff. So it's at Talk Carrier if you want to, but I wouldn't waste my time.
I love this girl.
I'm just being honest. Unless you like French bulldogs.
Yeah.
I post a lot of pictures of my dog.
He's really cute, by the way.
And he'll be hosting a Yappy Hour this Sunday if you have any good-looking dogs.
What the actual fuck is a Yappy Hour?
It's a happy hour for other dogs with non-alcoholic doggy beer.
Wait, where is this happening? Yeah. I don't want to bring Ripken.
Yappy Hour.
At my house, Yappy Hour. I try to do it once a month, socialize the dogs.
This is amazing.
Yeah.
Can I bring my cat? I've got to the point where I do want him to die. So I just throw him in the middle of the dogs and be like,
no, don't say that.
You're really like your own cat.
This commitment is over. Just throw him in.
I'm very allergic. That's actually why I wrote the cat song. I don't fuck with cats because this cat.
Good song.
Yeah, made me very, very allergic. But at the same time, it's a really cute cat. I like it. Well, Chris seems to think he's dumb.
He's an asshole, and he's very, very dumb.
I thought he was really cute, but okay.
He's a Zoolander cat. He looks cute, but he's horrifically, horrifically stupid.
Oh, like a leprechaun?
How dare you disrespect that man after he gave you a special gift.
He's not stupid. He's really nice and really good looking. Okay. I'm going to quit the show and I'll be back next week, guys.
Drunk Shopping Network. Drunk Shopping Network, guys. Drunk Admitting to Sexual Liaison Network. That's what we're doing right now.
You just outed me right now.
You were out the whole time.
I'm single now. You guys, I'm single,
Erin's
you know what?
Single, guys.
Okay, you know what? I'm going to be real right now. I'm going to bring out my next auction item that has to do with
the reason why I'm single.
Okay?
Are you single? Are you single?
You guys,
did you see how sadly I said that? I go, I'm not.
These are a pair of jeans. Wow, they look really big, don't they?
He's a big dude.
I know.
Oh, look at this stain.
Wait, I'm going to guess which ex-boyfriend this is.
Yeah, can you guess?
Definitely not the last. I don't know. I feel like he might have a nice body.
Yeah, he did.
He did. So I've seen it. Sorry.
Yeah, it's true.
He was a bartender, and this is no joke.
Yes.
I went to a bar and texted Erin. I was like, wow, the bartender at this bar is really fucking hot. He looks like a chunky Liam Hemsworth. And then she was like, and 2 seconds later, because she texted him, the bartender came up to me and he was like, this beer's on me, and here's a shot. And also, Erin says hi. I was like, what the fuck just happened in my life?
Yeah, you know, this goes, these are the bartender jeans.
Erin, darling.
I found these. Here's the story. I found these in my closet. Actually, yesterday I was cleaning, and I was moving some stuff around. I had, like, my case, like, fell off the thing that it was on. And then I found this box of stuff, and I was like, oh, my God, this must have been from months ago. When it had like all the stuff that I got him for Christmas, and he went back home to the state where he's from.
We're gonna need a black
light. Oh my God!
We're gonna need a black light.
Can we get a close? Yeah, can we get a close up of the black light, please?
I was just getting into my story.
We don't care about the story anymore because
jizz stains. That's why.
Who knows how often this person washed their pants? He's from Iowa.
What?
You would. You
like neither of you have ever never smelt jizz before.
Your nose was really close to
that. Oh, my God.
My mouth was really close to that.
Oh, God. Chris Saints. This is why we love him.
If someone buys us 6 shots, I'll lick it.
It's been so long, it doesn't even smell like it anymore. But, yeah, I found these in my closet. I found a box of stuff that I must have put in there when he went home for Christmas. And, yeah, anyway, so these actually made me really sad, and I really hope someone buys them because I really don't want to look at them anymore. They just make me depressed because I actually still kind of like him, even though we can't be together for reasons I don't want to go into, but he let me down and he broke my heart.
You let her down.
You let me down if you're watching, and I don't feel bad about this.
Burn him.
Is someone buying us another shot?
Lisa Stafford, thank you very much for buying us shots.
You know what? I need one right now, so I'm okay with that, Lisa. These jeans.
Thank you, Lisa Stafford.
Should we say what size they are in case they actually want to?
Yeah, these are Levi's 513 size sexy. That's what size they are. Size Erin will never have this again.
Size sexy smell used.
Erin needs trouble.
You guys, hold me. I'm so sad.
Type of man Hemsworthy.
Yeah, he's basically.
What are the chances he's watching right now?
Not at all, because he wasn't supportive of anything I do, and he wasn't there when I needed
him.
Wow.
What a loser.
So, yeah, he's not watching this. Go. But someone please buy them so I don't have to look at them ever again, please.
To Lisa Stafford, who bought us this shot.
Thank you. Bidding starts at -$5. Thanks, Lisa.
Bidding starts at free shipping, and just take it.
Yes, please. If no one buys us on the show, I will literally just give these to the next homeless person that I find, because I can't bear to look at them, because it really makes me sad. This is the realest I've ever been on camera before, by the way, because I am actually sad about it. I pretend like I don't care, part of my mind is checked out.
Keep going.
But there's part of my mind that's like, oh, man, that
sucks. Fake humor hiding real pain.
Absolutely. I mean, that's what comedy is about,
that's what
you know?
We do, guys.
Let's give him a shout out. His Twitter handle.
Should we go there? No, because I don't want him to gain followers from my pain.
If you go to,
at
Mitch the Buff Bartender,
no.
You'll find his. That's not his, right?
Oh, yeah. So, you guys, if you guys are watching right now, you see what just flew across the screen. Graphics for shots. You guys can buy this at any time. But actually, just don't buy us alcohol. Someone just buy these pants, please.
Just buy them.
You know what? He might be a famous actor one day. Probably not, but he might be.
Wow, you got dark, you got mean.
She's I'm bitter right now.
You're going through the 5 stages of grief by the
end
of the show.
We started talking about this item at 9:32. It is now 9:37, so I've had a whole 7-minute set right now of me just talking about my relationship problems. So why don't you talk about yours for a little bit, Chris?
Yeah. I don't have any problems.
Well, we're about to have to throw in the next segment pretty soon, so why don't you just tell us a quick little problem?
Oh, how about I tell you about the segment, and this will introduce to you how I don't have any problems. Yeah?
Always do this to me.
This is why Scott Pilgrim bombed at the box office. We went out on Tuesday night. We went to a very exclusive club. We told you about this.
Cloak and Dagger.
And then after that, because we've been held into this bougie little box all night, what we did was we got absolutely shit-faced on gin at my house. There was me and 2 ladies. One of them was Morgan. See, this is not relatable.
Who bought us a shot.
Yeah,
Thanks, Morgan.
And someone yelled Old Greg. I'm Old Greg from the Mighty Boosh. You ever seen that?
No.
Old Greg has a downstairs mix-up, which is a mangina. He's like, I have a mangina.
Wait, this Greg. Isn't a movie? I'm
TV show.
Okay.
TV show. And someone, and the one thing about old Greg, what he does is he goes, you want to drink Baileys from a shoe? You want to go to a club where people win each other?
No.
No, I know. Well, you,
I don't.
You're newly single. After you've been single for a while, your answers will change. But we were so drunk that when Lisa shouted, what was it? Do you want to, let's do Baileys from a shoe? Everyone else was like, yes. I was very, very drunk, but I wasn't too drunk that I pulled the camera out, I set it up, and we filmed the whole experience of us doing Baileys from a shoe.
My God.
That makes a difference.
This will become apparent. It's very confusing, but it does become apparent as the video goes on. But we called it the Old Greg Challenge.
Did everyone drink the Baileys, or was it just you?
Everyone that was awake.
Oh, God.
Yep.
Okay, let's watch this, you guys.
Let's do this.
And
sorry.
Try not
we're
to throw
sorry.
Up.
I'm Old Greg.
It's here, my love.
This dude Bailey's out of a shoe.
Yeah, but I think he's going to absorb. That's the only problem. Can we put some kind of lining in it so it doesn't absorb? I mean, I don't care. But I'm just thinking it's just going to, because it's canvas, it's just going to absorb it.
If you're just joining us, there was a Mighty Boosh episode where a character does Baileys out of a shoe.
You ever drunk Baileys from a shoe?
What? I'm Old Greg!
And we got drunk and we thought it might be a good idea to do Baileys out of a shoe.
I don't even drink. Like,
it's turning out to be a problem.
Do you want... This is an expensive shoe.
Okay, yeah, but it's going to absorb into this shoe, so give me that fucking shoe. Okay, these may have been $600, but they were definitely on clearance.
You'll do them one over yours, too.
God, this is still warm. I'm gonna have a warm baby.
Where's your shoe?
There's mine.
So what am I doing? I'll do that.
No, you're doing Morgan's shoe.
I am?
Yes.
Okay.
Do you want to do Chrissy's shoe?
Yeah.
Okay, then it's trade. Hold on, we have to swap so we've got the right shoes. She's doing your shoe.
Oh, yeah, because you're left. I'd say fill, drink, fill, drink, fill, drink, because if we fill, it's just gonna seep through.
Yeah, okay.
All right, so
you're worried
ready?
About your clearance shoes. Oh,
say,
no.
Say when. Say when.
Done.
Say when.
Done.
Go. Drink Baileys out of a shoe. Drink Baileys out of a shoe. Shit, that's a lot of shoe. There you go. Get it.
It's creamy. You are disgusting blind people.
Oh God.
The best is, you only have to wear one shoe with Baileys in, Morgan has to wear two.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
So that was a segment we like to call Drinking Baileys Out of a Shoe.
Hey guys, so...
Oh my God!
Yeah, that was at about 3 a.m. at my house on Tuesday night. So it was that was pretty recent.
I peed in a shoe.
Oh!
I was...
Single you is a drunk person.
No, I just half of a beer. Honestly, you guys, I've just been having a really rough time.
Oh, God, stop crying.
It's going to be fine.
I cry every episode, and I also quit the show every episode.
Oh.
Yeah, so...
Oh, there we go.
Yeah,
you're
going to
be
know.
Single for a while. There's going to be
no,
a lot of crying.
Not.
Don't get it
this
all out now.
Hot as shit. She's not going to be
that's
single.
True.
She'll just find another
What's going on? Oh, I just threw...
Oh, there's an exploding
I'm sorry.
Over there.
Do you want to give
that was my fault.
Do you want me to have that one? You have this
yeah.
one?
Yeah. Oh, I feel bad about that. Sorry, Dini. That's our guest for
there
the
you
next
go. You
segment.
One,
we're
going
to bring her on in a second. I thought that I could throw a Tecate and that she would catch it. But
let that be a lesson to you
I
all.
I am not maybe that good of a thrower, and I'm sorry, Dina. I care about you in so many ways, and that was, I don't know what I was thinking. Anyway, let's go back to the part where we're talking about how hot I am.
The hottest. Ever do it.
Oh my God. Weren't we going to do you a song in a bit?
Yes. The song?
The song.
The song.
Yeah.
Yeah, the song. Yeah,
the song.
We are. We're going to definitely debut it tonight. So
let's
do
this.
I'm really excited to
do
it. Yeah. All right. Well, Tatiana, do you want to say goodbye or do you want to hang on and like hang out for 15 minutes?
I mean, I'll just, you know, stand in the background and be a groupie.
Oh.
This song is so good. You guys
it
are
going
to die.
You want this dress while you do it?
The song was good.
Hold on. She's VIP and she actually heard it. She got a sneak peek, so she has an idea of what you guys are in store for. But the person who has the best idea of what's in store is our lead vocalist and singer-songwriter, Dina Renee. Come on out, Dina.
There she comes.
How are you doing?
It's me, Dina.
I've got surprises all around. I have to hide it.
What is that?
Dina has some auctions to...
I have a lot. I wore a hat just to be...
a hipster.
I need to be inspired, really.
Yeah?
Yeah.
To debut what's about to change the whole world.
What do I need to do to get you there?
Sing a song? Dance around?
Which song?
I don't know.
Keep going! Keep going!
Hey, I know you want me, I know you care. Just say whatever and I'll be there.
I like how that was the song that came out. Out of everything that could have been said.
Alright, should we do the chorus?
Baby, 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 baby shots. Baby, baby, baby shots. I always like to pretend it's spring break, so I like to actually cut a little bit in my beer and shotgun it.
Oh, do you want to do that right now?
I don't know if that's a good idea.
Okay, well, you're welcome to, because we like our guests to have fun on this show. And speaking of fun, I see a DVD down here that I think you really need to talk about, because this is exciting.
So since I was in high school, I heard my friend left a CD in my car, and I wasn't a big Erin fan because at the prime of his career, he was giving free concerts at Walmart.
We're not talking about Erin Darling. We're talking about a different Erin.
Yeah, that's why, it's confusing. This is the Erin I'm talking about. His name's Erin Carter. And when I know his song, it goes, it's beep, beep, have a good time. I'm Erin, the party's here. That's Erin Carter.
And I should start playing that song when I walk into places.
It's a very important
party
song
anthem.
Called Erin's Party that changed my entire life. And anyways, I blasted it all the way through high school, but I was completely kidding while, I thought it was a great song. Great lyrics. I'm sure six guys wrote the song. And
he's so cute. Erin.
I actually met him at the Grove, and I went up to him and I said, "Hi, Erin. I'm not a fan. I'm a friend." And
what did he say?
He was like, "Are you a fan now, babe?" And he kissed my cheek. So regardless,
Did you say yes or did you say no?
I mean, I said, "Yeah, I am, and I'll see you soon." So regardless,
as in later tonight.
I went to his concert and I found this on the stage and I asked him to sign it. So it's actually very dear to my heart.
And we
can also sign it as well.
You guys, it's signed by Erin Carter, a party starter legend.
Can we get a close-up on my phone for a sec? You wanted to see something embarrassing?
Is something happening?
What's happening?
Go in here on Erin Carter's Twitter page.
Wait, did he retweet you?
No. Go close in. It says, "Erin Carter follows you." But look at that follow button. But look at that. That follow button, not checked. Not following
back. Oh, yes!
You know Erin?
He knows of me, apparently.
Well, he retweeted me when I invited him to lunch.
He did?
Yes, on Periscope.
I'm just trying to ignore him. He comes around a lot. I'm just trying to keep him at arm's length, to be honest.
Well,
Wait, where is he coming? What?
Sliding,
I don't mean it like that.
Sliding right into my DMs.
I don't mean it like that.
You guys, he's not doing anything right now. He could totally come.
Let's call him. Call Erin Carter. Do you have his number?
Erin.
Can we plug it in? Can we plug in the thing?
It didn't work last time.
Do we have his phone number?
If we make a phone call, will it work? Let's just speakerphone it.
Well, show the picture I have of him, too, because it's very special.
Is he in your phone?
Erin?
Let's call Erin Carter. Are we just Googling his number?
You know what that actually says?
Oh, okay.
Put it on Twitter.
I bet he's changed it by now.
Nope. He was like, "Call me, fans." He's just bored. Well, anyways, if anyone wants to bid on this... It's very. He touched it, and he's a really big star.
He touched it with his Sharpie,
and
his Sharpie was all over that.
Yep, he touched me a little, and that's why I just walked right away.
I can't believe Erin's following me.
Yeah, wow.
This guy has a Twitter meltdown every day.
Oh, I haven't seen.
Have you not seen this?
He's worse than Kanye.
Oh, that makes me feel
bad. I think I did follow
him,
but he came out as a Trump supporter, so I was like, unfollow.
Are you joking?
No. Endorsed Donald Trump, right?
Wait, well, speaking of boy bands stuff, look, Chris, we have some items that we haven't even got to.
Oh, shit, sorry. So we're going to call this the what the fuck section. Everything that gets left at my house, whether a potential life partner drops an item on their way out of the door when I'm still asleep, or whether it's just something that gets dropped on the floor as I was, whatever. But these items sometimes get left at my house. This was one. This one goes in the what the fuck section. I put everything in the bottom left drawer of my cabinet. This is one of them.
I will buy that if no one wants this.
I bet Erin wants to be in.
Dude, Zane is the hottest.
Yeah, this
he
is
always has been.
This is pre Zane split.
I love Zane.
He's so hot.
He is.
I can't deny.
I love that.
God.
Well, yep. I'm sorry, wait. Someone had this at your place, you don't know who.
Well, it goes in the what the fuck section because are some items that I don't even remember seeing.
Well, I don't know.
And then in the morning, I'm like, where the fuck? I have this and I have a Katy Perry DVD.
But I'm like, where did this come from? If they're serious, it's funny. And if they're not serious, it's also funny.
But it's dirty. So something happened to it. Can we go in on the stain on the back, guys?
Yeah, but you know what? I think this would be great for transporting items. Like, this would be a great makeup bag. Like, I would use that for my makeup, you know?
You can put your weed in here.
You can put sandwiches in there.
You can do, yeah.
you can put your hair extensions in there.
I didn't mean weed sandwiches. I just meant sandwiches. But
Civil War. Oh my God, we could do a whole show on hair extensions that I have at my house.
Really?
I have a
Can we please?
Yeah, I've walked through the living room and I'm like, tenant.
What is it in your house no. that people just really? They can leave anything.
I don't know.
That sounds fun though. I feel like I'd leave just everything.
Well, with me, I think it's just, I don't think it's they want to leave it. I think they're just in a rush to leave.
I just think they're drunk.
No. That right? also, yeah. I mean, I think it's a chicken and egg. They're drunk, and then when they sober up, they're in a rush to leave.
Yeah, it's been a while since I've, been a part of this hookup culture, but I can't imagine waking up with someone.
Are you suggesting that I'm part of a hookup culture?
No, I'm not. No, not at all. I'm just saying the girls
who
might
life
be part
partner.
Of that culture.
Potential life partner.
I never would
and no judgment, because I did that in college, but I think if I did it, as a real adult, professionally that works and has goals and career and shit.
I don't think anyone's suggesting I'm a real adult.
I would be upset that I did that. I would regret my life choices. Okay, you guys are gonna quit the show.
What's happening? What are you talking about?
There we go. We also this is also in the what the fuck pile. It's an
I just like to get married serially.
Animal rescue color and activity book.
I want that.
I love cats, but they hate
this
me.
This wasn't even in the bag. This was another item that I just found in one
Please
of the mornings.
Just get a close-up of this dog.
But I may have bought this from a CVS or similar and not remembered and then got... You know when you go into the... You ever been in a CVS drunk and you go there to get beer at 2 a.m. before it closes and then you end up picking up a bunch of random stuff?
I would do that, yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
No, I know. I buy things because it's funny.
Wait, has this
even
coloring book been used? Is this brand new?
I don't know.
Well, there's no colors in it, so I'm guessing... This is prime for a kid. If anyone watching Drunk Shopping, we know that some kids watch this show because some kid drew a picture of Chris with his cat and the adults of this kid, because I'm not even going to call them parents.
That's amazing.
Because if you have a kid and you're letting them watch this show, you have a problem.
Yeah.
Barney and Friends, Sesame Street, Dora the Explorer, not this. If your kids are up right now watching this show, fuck you. You're a bad parent.
I think it's child culturally.
This is a kid's book.
Who's going to buy this but a little
Look at that.
Kid
this
that
is a kid's
know.
Book, and that's not
you
good.
I think it's the latest
that
member
is sexual.
Of Wonder
yeah.
This is sexual, and I don't approve. I went to Christian
I'm just
going to
write Ariana Grande on that.
I'm just letting everyone know that Erin is replacing Zayn. In One Direction. This is actually
every time you say that, I think you're talking about me.
I know.
And then
so
I feel
sorry.
Dumb. I'm like,
I always imagine Erin with an AH. Should we tell the hipster story before we
yeah,
show the video?
You know what? We
tell
should because
story.
We're going to debut this. And we actually have some auction related items to show you guys that have to do with the song. And the song is called Hey Hipster, Can I Wear Your Hat? Written by Dina and also with a rap by me and Chris. And Dina's the lead vocalist and the star of the music video. And we recorded this on Monday with my brother, who produced the track. We have an amazing producer named Leo. Why don't you tell us about Leo? Give Leo a shout out.
Leo's amazing. He's my producer that lives in Ireland. And I literally just hey, do you have a track we can use for this song that I made up when I was at a bar about 6 months ago? Because there was way too many hipsters. There was house music playing.
Which bar was it?
It was No Vacancy. And I just kept walking around being like, hey, hipster. And that's how the song started on Periscope. Everyone was just like, oh my God, you have to make this a real song. And I go, it is a real song, and it will be. And Erin said the exact same thing. So literally, would not be done without any of this show. I'm very grateful. I'm so excited to show this week's video.
Yeah, we had a blast. And before we debut it, we're just going to tell you some of the lovely auction items that we have related to what you're going to see in this video. And two of those items are the hats that Chris and I are wearing right now.
Oh, they are?
Yeah, they're featured in the music video because, as you will see, there are a lot of hats that were worn in this video because the actors that played hipsters, which also were played by, we should give them shout-outs, Ryan Broms, Molly Merkel, who you guys saw on the show last week is Janice.
Merkel, that is a hipster name. name.
Yeah, Janice, yeah. The lesbian, the lesaholic.
Lesaholic.
Yes, she is
As
in
am
this.
I, and when I visit
Christopher Hub. Sullivan, our friend, he's a photographer that Chris didn't think would do the video because he's actually a hipster.
Oh, he did it? I didn't see it all the way through.
Yeah, you'll see it. He did it. Yeah, he did your rap segment. So we're really excited. Unfortunately, Chris was not able to be in the video because he was working that day, and we only had 3 hours to shoot it because I had to get it into post really quick so that you guys could see it today and we could premiere it here on Drunk Shopping Network, which we are stoked about. We have a great friend, Michael Bozzoli, who shot everything as our director of photography and was there for us last minute. Zach Darling produced the track and remixed it. And again, Leo was the one who provided us the track. And Dina, it was her idea. So, you know, let's just throw the segment and maybe we'll talk about these auction items after.
Okay. Let's do it.
Okay, let's do it.
Hey, hipster. Hey, hipster. Hey, hipster. Hey, hipster, can I wear your hat? Hey, hipster, can I wear your hat? Hey, hipster, can I wear your hat? Hey, hipster, can I wear your hat?
Hey, hipster, can I wear your hat? Los Lobos, button mash. I take my latte, soy non fat. Bernie Sanders, Democrat. I pick up chicks at the laundromat. Gentrification, I'm into that. Hey, hipster, can I wear your hat? PBR, I'll drink that. Where'd you get that hat?
An obscure store no one's ever heard of before. I have a Prius, it's four-door. Facial hair from the Civil War.
Where did you get your hat? Were you born with it? Just give me one chance to be cool. Can I borrow that hat? Hey, hipster, can I wear your 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 hat? Hey, hipster.
Summer anthems right now.
That's what that
hey
is.
Hipster,
can I
wear
your
hat? It is now that we've done it here, it's going to be live on my YouTube channel and actually in Chris's and
just everywhere.
Dina's, basically everyone's right
and
now.
You can
so.
Buy it on Spotify soon. In yeah. Week when it gets on there.
It's going to hit
weeks.
Spotify.
And yeah. If you really, really want to be a part of the Hey Hipster movement, we have this item that we're going to auction off in our last minute. It is the lyrics to the rap that Chris and I wrote. And we recorded briefly right before we shot this on Monday night. Yeah, this is sombrero, yes. Beret, yes. Fedora. Yeah, you guys, these are the lyrics
Those
that
the
I had
lyrics.
On my phone that we printed out and decided what the rap was going to be. And so you guys can own this. Chris and I will sign it if you're crazy enough to want to auction on something like this. But who knows? It could be the next viral hit. You never know. And also these hats. The one that Chris took off were also
Sorry.
Used in the video. And this
well,
one
it was well itchy.
Also. And if you guys are interested in these items, go check them out.
They're
at,
really expensive. And buy my song on iTunes, my other song.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, check it out. CSBodyPiercing.com/XSN. That's where all these items will be until tomorrow night. And then, of course, follow Dina Renee on social media.
support her.
You don't have
and
to do that. Just buy my song on iTunes. It's only a dollar.
Just there do it. And support us, you guys. Come back for more DSN. Tatiana, come out and let's say goodbye to our lovely audience.
If you're a hipster,
love meeting you.
Wear your hat.
Just let them wear your hat.
Just if you're a hipster, just be down with
don't
it.
Don't be
okay?
a shitster. Be a hipster. Just let them wear your hat.
Let them wear your hat.
Don't be a dickster.
Yeah. Okay, that's our next song. That's our next song.
Don't be a cunster.
Oh, man. Well, right. Thank you guys for joining us for another episode of who? DSN. Chris
Thanks
Saint, Erin, darling.
Who do we have on next week?
Who do we have on next week?
Who do we have on next week?
We have Camilla Cleese. She's a good friend of mine, daughter of John Cleese, a Monty Python fame, if you guys know. She's an amazing comedian. And I think we have
Erin.
Josh Dickerson, who's another comedian.
And Erin.
Two stand-ups.
Nailed it.
Yeah.
On the spot, and you nailed
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah. I'll be back, too. I'll be back. And Chris will be back.
Yeah, we'll
but you
be
know
back.
Who won't be back?
Us. We're here.
Dear Renee,
spirit.
Tatiana Carrier, you guys
I mean,
follow
I might,
them.
Actually, I might just be I'm behind
I
that.
I might just be here.
You guys should
I
be
might
here,
live
actually.
Right next door.
Just come hang out.
Casually reading
drinking.
You guys are really entertaining, so I just like to watch.
Yeah, absolutely. Come
and
back anytime. Actually, we hope you guys do come back because this was my favorite episode that we've done thus far.
Fucking Erin.
Erin's single.
Get off my nuts, Erin.
Yes, sadly. And just buy these jeans, someone. For the love of God.
They're great jeans.
Yeah, if you build like Wolverine, just buy the jeans.
Yeah, Hugh Jackman, the jeans are available. All right, guys, thank you so much for joining us for this episode of Drunk Shopping Network. We are here every Thursday night, 9 p.m. at XSN. We love you guys. Peace. Buy our shit. Bye.